Hey friends, this is Sketch Dirt and I'm Marla, and today we're drawing 3D letters I, J, K, and L. We're working our way through the entire alphabet. We're doing them 4 letters at a time. I have divided my paper out into 2.5 by 3 inch squares for the first 2 squares, and the 3rd square where the K is, that's 3 by 3. And then the last one is 2.5 by 3, and the paper is 11 by 14. I'm using a 2B pencil. And to start, I am just sketching out the basic letters before I get started, and now I'm getting going on the actual 3-dimensional shapes. I'm doing that so that way, just to get started, it's easier to know where you're going to put those 3D shapes. It gives you a sense of the space that they're gonna take up. And I've started with the I. These 4 letters, probably, in my opinion, the easiest 4 letters in the alphabet to draw. It's a good grouping for this video, since all of them have very similar characteristics. Also, when you're drawing, don't worry about kind of a lot of extra lines and making a mess of things, because this is like, you're getting a feel for it. And as you see, as the video goes along, we're going to clean up all these lines and get you the letters that you want. The finished product is going to be very clean and neat. And right now I'm drawing the K, and you're going to see when I draw this K that I make a big mess of it. Like, this K is a hot mess. But by the end of the video, it's cleaned up and looking good. And that's the whole point of these videos, is just to kind of see what my process is and then apply that to your own process. So I'm just going through and sketching this out, and you can see when I drew that first K, I saw what space it took up, but then when I'm drawing the 3-dimensional K, I'm putting the lines where I feel like they need to go based on that. And I'm getting the L penciled in here. This is probably my favorite series so far. I really love typography. I love drawing letters. And now I'm going through and I'm erasing everything. I've said this in every video. I did not want to fill this with a bunch of erasing, but I think in order to see what my process is and see how I go back through and just clean everything up and kind of place the lines back in, I think that's really helpful. And right now I'm just re-penciling in the I and putting those lines back in where I want them to be in a cleaner way. And that serif on the J, the first time I drew it, I felt like it was a bit short. And so once I got everything erased, I put that back in and made that a bit longer. I have this K cleaned up, as you can see. It's looking a lot neater. And also, these lines aren't meant to be perfect. This is hand lettering, and so that's really the beauty of doing this, and instead of doing it on the computer, is that the lines don't look perfect and they have that hand touch that's really personal. And now I'm going to take a piece of tissue paper and show you how to draw these 3D letters in a way that's a lot easier than just guessing. For this video, we're going to be doing the guessing portion of it, but I want to keep showing you guys these little tricks in these videos and these different methods for doing this that achieve the exact same result. And you do what's easiest for you. And so for this one, I've got a large piece of tissue paper, and I'm basically putting the letters together how I want them. I'm basically laying it out on the page the same way you would kind of on a computer, but you're doing it by hand. And then the trick to this for the 3D portion is you offset it. as however much you want. I do my, for this series, I've done mine about a quarter to a half an inch, but you can make your three-dimensional letters as large or as small as you want. And this applies whether you're using pencil or chalk or paints. It applies for any of those mediums. You can see how that works out. If you had like a whole layout you were doing, you could just spell out the words exactly like that and then take a picture on your phone or with your camera and import that into your computer and then outline that in your computer program. And now we're getting started drawing the letters by hand. And the reason why I wanted to do it like this is because when you do this, you get to, it's not even necessarily guesswork. You're putting in that three-dimensional shape the way you feel will look best for your design. And that's part of like the expressiveness and that personal touch that I really want to convey in this series. And I'm going to get this L penciled in, and then we're going to get ready for the fun part, which is shading those three-dimensional sides. Now, when I shade these sides, this is where, in the first portion of the video, when you had the rough lines, we went through and we erased everything. And now with this portion, with those same rough lines, I leave them there, and this shading does the cleanup for you, and you can go back through and you can do this shading to give that three-dimensional look and then darken the areas where you want more emphasis or just darken up the lines to create the letter shape. And this is it. This is how you draw three-dimensional letters I, J, K, and L. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions or comments or ideas for videos, let me know in the comment section. I'd love to hear from you. Thank you so much. This is Sketch Dirt, and I'm Marla.